Let's go back to 2019 for a moment. Ubuntu says it's dropping all 32-bit support going forward. This is what we call in the industry a stupid idea, because most notably at the time, this was going to break 32-bit Wine and Steam. This was about a year into Proton having been a thing that existed at all. So there was quite a bit of uproar about this, and you may notice that no one talks about Ubuntu being something you can't game on. And the reason for that is this never actually happened. The report did happen. They were going to do this. And then someone at Valve told them to stop being stupid. Pierre Lou Griffiths, Ubuntu 90.10 and future releases will not be officially supported by Steam or recommended to our users. We will evaluate ways to minimize breakage for existing users, but will also switch our focus to a different distribution currently to be disclosed. And one of the replies to this was from Neil Gumper. How about coming over to Fedora? We still provide full multilib support and have up-to-date graphics and sound stacks, which in retrospect is a really, really funny comment. Why is it a funny comment? Well, as first reported on by Gaming on Linux, Fedora Linux devs discuss dropping 32-bit packages. Potentially bad news for Steam gamers. So, it's literally the exact same thing that happened with Ubuntu 6 years ago. The context is a bit different. More stuff is working, but it's still a problem. As always, when we're discussing something like this, it is a change proposal. This means it is subject to change and may not be brought into a future version of Fedora. But drop 32-bit multilib support on x86-64 and stop building packages for i686. Fedora stop providing kernel packages, installer images, and stop publishing i686 package repositories with Fedora 31. However, packages were by default still built for i686 architecture since they're required for running 32-bit applications on x86 hosts. Multilib. Since Fedora 37, leaf packages, i.e. packages that are not depended on by any other packages, can simply stop building for i686 without any reason, which has allowed package maintainers to focus their work on architectures where packages are actually shipped to users. This change proposal implements the next two and last steps. Packages built for i686 architecture are no longer included in x86-64 repositories, dropping multilib support, i.e. support for running 32-bit user space on a 64-bit host, and packages are no longer built for the i686 architecture. And the targeted release is set for Fedora Linux 44. That is not the next version, but the version after that. The reason why it's set to the version after is there's not exactly a set time to do this, because this would be a big change, because as I mentioned, the whole Steam and Wine problem. The Wine one isn't as much of a problem. We'll get to that in a moment. But Steam, Steam's still a problem, but is not the only problem. This effectively breaks the FEX rootfs we have been producing since Fedora Linux 42 for x86 emulation on Arch 64. We rely on being able to include x86 64 and i686 libraries to produce a Linux environment that's viable for gaming on Linux ARM machines. In case you don't know, Neil is involved in many, many things. One of those things is the Asahi Linux project. However, Steam is still a big blocker. And you know how long it's been a blocker for? Literally forever. So, opened October 1st, 2014. Not working in 64-bit only distributions. Example, CentOS 7. This has been an open issue for over a decade, and is still an issue now. Not because of gaming. Not at all because of gaming. A lot of people seem to think that it's the Steam games that would break. No, it's the client. So, as of Wine 9.0, it added a thing called WoW 64, where you can basically run your 32-bit applications within a 64-bit environment. This wasn't stable back in Wine 9, but as of a couple of days ago, Arch Linux is swapping over to doing this, swapping their Wine build purely over to WoW 64. There are some drawbacks. There's some performance issues with 32-bit OpenGL applications, but considering a 32-bit OpenGL application is probably going to be pretty old, you can probably brute force it anyway, and if you do have any 32-bit prefixes, they will need to be regenerated, which is annoying, but if you know it's there, then it's not that big of a deal. It is the Steam client that has the 32-bit dependencies. So how does the author suggest we deal with this problem? It's not explicitly mentioned in the change proposal, but a workaround for Steam would be to use the Flatpak, which includes the necessary 32-bit libraries. It has some limitations compared to the native RPM package, but not nearly as many as they used to be. I've been running the Steam Flatpak for gaming exclusively for years and haven't hit any Flatpak-specific issues. So it is miles ahead of the Steam Snap. The Steam Snap is literally unusable. I don't know what they were thinking with it. I don't know why anyone bothered to try to make that. But in the documentation for Steam VR for Linux, Steam VR for Linux cannot run properly within the Steam Snap or Steam Flatpak packages as they break both Direct Rendering Manager DRM leasing and asynchronous reprojection. The native distribution package should be used instead. Now, I know there are workarounds that people are going to post, and that is, yes, absolutely a thing that exists. However, it is not supported by Valve. It is a hack. It is a workaround. And if something goes wrong, well, there's also the matter of projects like GameScope, which also do not function correctly with the Flatpak, which is also great. Then there is the matter of the downstream projects that build off of Fedora, or more accurately, build off of Ubuntu, which build off of Fedora, like Bazite Linux, and we have Kyle, the founder, right here. As much as I'd like this change to happen, it's too soon. This change would kill off projects like Bazite entirely, right as Fedora is starting to make major headway in the gaming space. Neil Gomper already pointed out basic use cases that would be broken, even if someone built the packages Steam itself needs to function. There are other things alongside Steam that also break. It's also causing irreparable damage to Fedora from a PR standpoint. I have been inundated all day with people sharing news articles and being genuinely concerned Steam is going to stop working on their Fedora / Bazite machines. I would argue, not only should this change be rejected, the proposal should be rescinded to limit further damage to Fedora as a project. Perhaps open a separate one to talk about changing build architecture to build fewer 32-bit packages. And obviously he's in a much bigger position than I am when it comes to gaming, but I have spoken to people in the past couple of hours who are directly worried about this, who either use Fedora or something built off of Fedora, and are genuinely in a situation where they're thinking, do I need to migrate to something different? Or were considering going to Bazite, who are now, you know, reconsidering their plans. This would also break OBS game capture of games, since that requires a 32-bit user space graphic stack. I believe he's referring to OBS VK capture. This isn't referring to capturing your entire screen. It's about capturing specifically the game window through the system of nicely capturing game windows. Without any additional context, I think it's reasonably fair to say, why wouldn't Bazite just go and build these packages themselves? Let's just imagine that Fedora wanted to move entirely away from gaming. They don't care to break Steam. That's not what's happening. But let's just imagine that was the case. They're a distro. Technically not a distro. It's an image-based system based off of another image-based system that's based off of the distro, which is Fedora. But like, it's basically a distro and they can build packages to put into their image. Why couldn't they just go and do that? To that, Kyle says, I'm speaking as its founder. If this change is actually made as it is written, the best option for us would be to go ahead and disband the project. This has been getting shared around Reddit quite a bit and has been getting shared without any additional context. And people have been kind of freaking out. It's like, oh my God, is Bazite about to die? Oh my God. Nothing is settled, right? Like, nothing at all is settled, and there are going to be ways they can deal with it if that does happen. This did initially seem like a weird statement to me, because even if it's not in Bazite, couldn't it be done in Ubuntu? Because the other things based on Ubuntu would probably want those packages as well. I asked Kyle directly about this, and this is what he said. There would be so many packages to maintain that would need to be kept in lockstep with Fedora as to make that relationship untenable. We would not have the manpower or the time to ensure that worked, let alone it was stable. Effectively, what they would need to do is like manage like a mini distro of the 32-bit packages that was always aligned with what was going on in Fedora. So, yes, it could be done, but it's a lot of additional work. If this shipped today, to accomplish this, we'd need to, 1, build all of the packages Steam needs in copper or similar, build a custom version of Proton with experimental WoW64 features turned on, 3, instruct all users to manually change their Steam settings to use that Proton version because the ones that Valve provides don't have that, and 4, tell anyone using OBS Game Capture they're just going to have to give up. I think this proposal isn't viable for the next decade with these criteria. Instead, limiting what's built seems like the more realistic approach and the one with less negative PR and brand damage. Now, of course, with there being a change proposal being made, even though a lot of people are really, really, really against this, and if you couldn't tell, I'm kind of against this as well, there are people that do support this being done. From Michael Catanzaro, we cannot allow proprietary software that we cannot fix to hold back Fedora development. Removing x86 support is critical. It's long past time to do this. Thank you, Fabio. It's not clear that there is any actual serious problem here anyway. The strongest argument I see above is I don't like Flatpak, and now I have to install Steam via Flatpak rather than via RPM like I would prefer, which is just not a very convincing use case, which is not at all the use case that people were proposing anyway. It's always good to see people ignoring the use cases because it's inconvenient to what their objective is. The issue is the Steam Flatpak does not work, and it can't work because Steam does not work in a Flatpak environment. It's gotten better, but there are things that still don't work, like VR still being broken without doing some hacks, and GameScope also being broken. And I'm sure other things are broken as well, and the big problem there is Valve does not care to support the Flatpak. The only official package on Linux is the deb and then what they have on SteamOS. They're not going to support the Flatpak anytime soon. In a later reply, he says, I don't know how important GameScope is. If you don't know what the use case that people have is, why are you commenting here? Here we have Neil's full position, which I personally agree with. I object to the premise of this proposal because it breaks core use cases that we in Fedora and critical downstreams depend on. I would much rather split the build tag and identify the set of source packages needed to be built for x86 and have that subset auto-built when the packager submits a build to the normal tag for it. That way it looks the same from the packager point of view and the scope is drastically reduced for the content set for x86. Basically, build the minimal set of packages and only rebuild stuff when you need to rebuild it. When Kyle brings up basically the same point, Fabio, the original author, says, we've already tried this, but it doesn't scale. The way things currently work, packages need to be opted out of building for x86 individually and in order not to break things, starting from packages that are already leaf packages with regards to x86. But I don't think there's a good way to re-architect our whole build pipeline from building on certain architectures if needed to you explicitly opt out from all architectures if needed, but you need to opt in for this special one. Even if doing this were possible, engineering resources would likely be better spent elsewhere. Even with all of these reasons to keep x86 around, it's still a problem that needs to be dealt with. As a maintainer of a rather diverse set of packages in Fedora, I've seen anecdotally that the burden of dealing with x86 has been gradually but continuously increasing across the distribution. Not all packages have been impacted yet, but each release cycle comes with new 32-bit issues, especially as upstreams stop testing on 32-bit architectures and bit rot sets in, and upstreams are more and more likely to react to bug reports by simply declaring 32-bit platforms unsupported. If we choose to do nothing, the situation is likely to be much worse in 2 years, 4 release cycles, and the risk of a big part of the dependency tree suddenly collapsing in a way that is difficult to repair will continue to increase. At best, many hours will be wasted on fixing packages that nobody will ever use. Obviously, some of the packages are being used by the Steam client, but a lot of the packages are not necessary. If we implement no change, then we still commit to the labor and risk inherent in trying to keep most of the distribution working on i686, which is increasing over time, even if we do not act. If we proceed with this proposal, then we completely remove the impact on packages, but commit to the impact on users, which has been heavily discussed in this thread, although there's perhaps not a consensus on the exact details that impact and how much of it could be mitigated. If we pursue making i686 opt-in using an ELN-like approach, the user impact of the second option could be avoided, and the package impact and risk of the first option could be somewhat lessened, perhaps to sustainable levels, but somebody would have to completely understand what would be required, very carefully prove it out, and implemented. What is clear is that there is no real do-nothing option here in the medium term. Even if nothing is done, things are going to continue to degrade. Whilst there are some arguments about how this should be dealt with, most people are acting in good faith. Most people are acting in good faith and actually want to deal with the problem. Yes, it's a problem for the users, but it's also a problem for the distro, and something needs to be done about this. On this matter, Neil says, if I assume the Steam client isn't getting ported to 64-bit x86 anytime soon, which it really should be, Valve, fix that, and that nobody develops any 32 on 64 thunking mechanism for Linux libraries, then we have to think about how far we may need to keep it. We can put this off retiring i686 quite a long time, since each Fedora release is only supported for 13 months. The last release we could reasonably maintain support for 32-bit x86 is Fedora 65, released in October 2036, if I got my math right. Since its EOL would be November 2037. Now that might seem like a random date pulled out of his ass, that's because of the 2038 problem. And if you want to start dealing with 32-bit libraries past 2038, you really need to make sure you're not dealing with time in any of them, because you're going to start seeing problems very quickly. Carl George also chimes in on this matter, having the best Fedora badge I have ever seen. I love my corporate shield badge. Saying quite a bit of stuff, but ending off by saying, deferring this change a release or two would buy us time to see how that plays out. Kyle also agrees wholeheartedly to this as well. On the topic of OBS VK capture, this was literally said during the recording of this video. Why can't it use the screencast portal? Does it not perform well enough? The latest comment by Neil Gomper right down the bottom here. The screencast portal has a history of completely locking up the desktop when trying to capture games. It cannot keep up at all. That probably should be dealt with. Yeah, that just should be dealt with. This is still very much an evolving story, and I don't know where it's going to go. With people like Neil being involved, with people like Kyle being involved, I don't know why Glorious Eggroll from the Nabara project and, you know, Proton GE hasn't commented in here either. Maybe he's busy. He seems like someone who'd get involved in here as well. With people in Fedora that do legitimately care about gaming as an actual use case, my hope is this doesn't go badly, because there is a very real chance that people that don't play video games have a chance to entirely brick gaming on Fedora. Yes, there is the flat pack, but the flat pack is buggy. I hope that doesn't happen. I really hope it doesn't, because Fedora is becoming a bigger and bigger choice for gamers, thanks to things like Bazite, thanks to things like Nabara, and just general upstream Fedora. We'll wait and see. And if something bad does come out of this, I will be sure to make another video. Yeah. Anyway, if you like the video, go like the video. If you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, Liberapay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and let's hope this doesn't go badly. Like this.